You know what? Before I start this, I gotta shave. Okay, that's better. I had a shave, but I have this, like, whenever I see my parents, their cats, Charlie and Boris, for some reason, Boris usually gives me an irritation on my face if I have a beard, and I've got, like, a little itch mark. It's not like a bite, it's not a spot, it's literally just where it's itchy. It'll be gone tomorrow, but, yeah, so, shaved, had a little trim of the beard, feeling much better. So, today is, not much is gonna be happening today's vlog. Yesterday's vlog was, it was okay. It was cool to, like, film, pets and stuff, but, honestly, nothing much happened. I always feel like the vlog isn't entertaining if not much is happening, and, you know, if not much is happening, I've gotta substitute that with what I'm gonna talk about. If I've got nothing to talk about, then, you know, it's like, shit. Anyway, don't worry about it. We'll work on stuff. So, I'm filming right now off of my SLR. My tripod has this cool little handle. So, I basically made my SLR, like, almost like a night tick. So, I hold on to the body of the tripod with a cool carry handle that it has, and then the camera's just pointing directly at me. So, yeah, I can actually point and shoot. I just autofocus this thing on me. It's like 3 feet away. And yeah, all I need now is a, what's it called? A microphone. And it will sound so much better. And then I can walk around like this. It's a little unpractical because it's quite large, but who cares? Anyway, yeah, so today I am going to be painting some stuff. So if you weren't aware, because I never told you. So I have, some spray paint cans, I guess, spray cans of paint that I've been using. I have like a gray that I used for my PC, and then when I got some airsoft stuff, basically the theme I'm going for in terms of color is OD green, tan, and brown. And I bought, because the goal is to paint my sniper rifle its own custom color, and I bought this green. I didn't really think about it, but I thought, oh, that's a good foliage green. I didn't think about it matching my camo and just in general have a theme. It doesn't. It's very horrible, and I painted my goggles, my mesh goggles with it. I don't know if you can see that. It's disgusting. It doesn't match. Here, look, I'll show you on my gun. Because on my AK, this fell down. On my AK, the rail system, I've got rail covers, which are in OD green. And then on top of that is the wood part, because I think it looks cooler like that. See what I mean? See how it doesn't match? Also, I'm going to take, I don't know why, but the company that I bought this ergonomic pistol grip off, they sent me two. I don't know why. I still don't have mags or a battery for that. Yeah, so I have two of those pistol grips. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paint the pistol grip, and I'm gonna paint that top rail, the wooden rail, with OD green, which finally arrived. It took a while, but yeah, it's here. So this will match, it'll look nice, it'll have a perfect theme, and then honestly, I'm not sure if I want to paint the whole thing green, because I think it would look cooler where there are parts of green and the majority is black. We'll see, I don't know yet. So that's what I'm going to do right now. And before we do that, I want to thank people that have left questions and stuff. I know I wanted to say something in today's vlog from yesterday. I can't remember what it was. I'll probably remember later on. Hold that thought. Okay, so it's been about an hour and a half, maybe. Probably 2 hours, actually, because I've been doing a lot of editing and stuff. I want to see how the paint has dried, how well it's turned out. Bear in mind, when I'm spraying it, I'm no professional. I don't know how to properly do it. But the point is, it doesn't need to be clean and perfect. It's going on a gun that I want to look weathered. I want it to look banged up. So it's not, you know, essential that it's perfectly covered, it requires two coats and all that such, it doesn't matter. It's gonna get fucked up anyway, so if it's gonna get fucked up, I don't have to worry about it looking perfect. Let's see. So the pistol grip is pretty nice looking. Perfect OD that I wanted. It's got like a... It looks like it's been done kind of shitty, which is perfect, to be honest. Am I in focus? There we go. It's dry. It hasn't dripped where I thought it was actually gonna. I'm not sure about this. It will probably... Because it's like, it's a, you know, it's ABS plastic. My only concern is that the paint isn't going to stick. And it'll just wear off, like, within the first game's usage. The goggles turn out pretty well. I'm not too fussed about the material being black. But as long as the front is black, it's good. That doesn't need to be green. But, sorry, as long as the front is green, then we're good. So this turned out quite well. The upper piece of wood has got like some, I think you can see it just there, like where it dripped, there's like a thick layer at the top. I don't think it's actually dry yet, but no, it's dry. I just don't want to put too much pressure on it. Let's put it on the gun. In the previous vlog yesterday where I talked about having the Skyrim, the upper rail, I use this for the Skyrim time lapse. The reason why I don't use the upper rail is because there's meant to be a gas pipe here. And because there isn't, it looks empty. Okay, there we go. So it's on there. That OD green actually looks pretty nice, to be honest. It's a bit light. Yeah, it's a bit light, but, you know, it's whatever, actually. With a bit of the grey, I don't know where the grey is, on top of that, it might look pretty nice. Alright, let's change the pistol grip. Okay, so that's what it looks like without the pistol grip. That's the motor, so that's driving the piston back and forth. Okay. Not bad. Not bad at all, actually. If only these were the same green. I wonder if I should paint those. I don't know, let me know in the comments if you think that would be a good idea. Because this is more of a... I don't know. It's obviously like a light plastic, but I don't know if it should get it done. It will match, but maybe it looks kind of cool without. The only missing part is obviously the mags, and they will be the same color as this. Probably closer to this, to be honest. But yeah, I think it looks pretty sweet now. Okay, so when I was outside filming, the painting and stuff, the first thing I did was put the camera down on the tripod, right? And I put it down on the ground and I was like, oh, this is a little unbalanced. Let me bring the back leg up a bit so it leaned, the camera leant forward a bit more. As I did that, the camera fell, landed lens first into the grass. It seems clear. There's no real scratches on it. Like, it looks like there's a little bit of dirt smudge. But there's no scratches. I was really worried that I fucked up because it was fully extended and the lens was out focus. So as soon as I pulled it up, the lens had been pushed inward. So luckily we're fine. But news. The floor is clean. That's just because I'm cleaning downstairs. This is just because cables. Let me get out of autofocus here and put it on manual. There we go. Okay, look, see? We've got some cleanness, got my shoes in there, clean-ish floor. My bathroom is actually kind of terrible. Not for cleanliness, but just because it's gross, as in like, whoever designed that bathroom and the size of it, it's just fucking... Anyway, so all the shit is like on my bed for now, whilst I gotta hoover the floors, which I'll do tomorrow because this takes like 5 days. Done that. Stairs are done. There's a bag just here. That white little thing, which is all going to charity. My shoes are nice. Gotta do laundry, gotta do plates. And here is relatively cleanish despite stuff that's on the ground. I've still gotta frame this, and that's, there's presents being sent out in that. One thing, let me just figure out how to focus this. Okay, so I'm in my kitchen. I've done that much of the cleaning up. I know it's not a lot, and I've still got a bit to go. Actually, this should go over here. But we're in my kitchen, and I've got some stuff ready. Some things aren't put away tomorrow. This will be done 100%. As I said before, I still got laundry to do. But we're gonna make some chicken, and today starts the portion size reduction from this size plate to this size plate. 3 pieces of chicken and some frozen veg. Now, I know that, like, I've actually filled that plate, but realistically, I don't know if it's like a placebo effect or not. Like, perhaps that portion would be the same on the big plate. I don't know. Maybe I did too much veg. I'm not sure, but there's 2 breasts there and a portion of veg. You know, if I make that any smaller, I'll starve. But right now, that's a start. So today is day 1 of portion size reduction. And I'm gonna fucking destroy that shit, so I'll catch you in a bit. It's like 7 o'clock in the morning. I had my Huel, and I stayed up all night, but I was being productive. I'm composing, so in the next couple of days, I'll probably show you something from it, but for now, I'm going to sleep. So, good night.